The current budget is coming at the back of a very, very different year. All of us have seen tremendous change in our professional as well as personal lives. Digital has become a very integral part in many things we do in the new normal. India has embraced digital, and it's expected by 2025 the digital economy would contribute about a fifth of the overall economic activity. Consequentially, there is a huge demand and need for digital infrastructure. It is at the back of this that we set out expectations to provide impetus to digital infrastructure by treating it as a strategic priority in the current union budget. The impetus can be provided across the three pillars of incentivization, enforcement, and negotiations. There is an opportunity to incentivize across the digital infrastructure value chain. Let's take, for instance, the data center market. India can become a hub for data center market. Research and development, where India is already doing quite well, with close to 1,140 R&D centers opened by MNCs in India. We can continue the momentum with the right allocations. Manufacturing of IT, telecom, and digital equipment products can be propelled with the right policy support. Secondly, industry will be looking forward to the simplification and providing clarifications to dispel the ambiguities in the digital taxation. Some of the recently introduced taxes levies by the Indian government, being an offshoot of BEPS initiative, are equalization levy and significant economic presence. While the equalization levy provisions were introduced with an intention of taxing non-resident e-commerce providers not having a presence in India, the provisions has ambiguities which has resulted in speculation amongst various MNCs. The government should provide clarity around availability of tax credit of equalization levy in the home country, scope of the term digital facility, applicability of equalization levy on intra-group services, dichotomy between the date of applicability of provisions and the date of applicability of exemption provisions, and so on. The significant economic presence provisions, which target non-residents having considerable income from India without a physical presence, have evident overlap with the withholding tax and equalization levy provisions. Absence of clear provisions and threshold for applicability of the same could lead to further ambiguities. So in order to avoid these ambiguities and related litigation, the government should either further defer applicability of SEP or provide clarifications on the provisions. Also, with the SEP provisions being introduced, it is high time new PE profit attribution rules are issued in order to provide clarity on the quantification of income having nexus with India. As a third pillar, government can take a lead as a key negotiator for industry to propel the growth of digital infrastructure. In summary, with the right incentivization, required enforcement related policy support, and government taking a lead as a key negotiator, the industry is looking forward to the impetus that can be provided for the digital infrastructure so that India can become a preferred investment destination for this very important sector.